So here we go. Marler and Collins bring him out of four, green in the air. Three wide, Chastain to the bottom. Marler will get the advantage. Here comes Kenny Collins, threading the needle out of turn number two. Oh, did he make the move? And now a slide job by Marler. Collins answers back. Three wide again. Now they're three wide for the lead out of two, and Kenny Collins will take the advantage. Ivan Ant Lloyd wants a piece of the action. He'll go to the outside of Chastain. Now Ivan Ant will stalk the X-15. King in fifth. Sixth is Ledford. Barnett mixing it up with Shelton. Kenny Collins in command. Wow. Mikey Marler finds himself in the number two spot. Sean Chastain halfway this time. Four in the books, four to go. Now Marler starting to find his groove as he closes the gap on the 1C of Kenny Collins. Collins with about a five car length advantage as he stretches the lead down the backstretch. Dent running fourth, King fifth. Sixth is Ledford. Seventh is Ronnie Payne. Shelton and Barnett continue to battle for eight. White flag coming up. Kenny Collins will work it out at turn number four. Marler tracking him down. One lap to go. That battle between Shelton and Barnett continues. Checkered flag's going to wave. Here comes Mike Marler, a last-ditch effort. Just going to come up short. Kenny Collins will win it. Marler second. Third will go to Chastain. Fourth will go to Ivanette. Fifth to King. Sixth will go to the A-19 of Ledford. Seventh to Ronnie Payne. Eighth and final transfer spot will go to Scott Shelton. Kenny Collins made the move that won the heat for him when he threaded the needle three wide out of turn number two. The Covert, Georgia driver will start fifth tonight. So here we go. They bunch up nice and tight in three. Won't take long to run eight laps, that's for sure. Out of four, they fire. Oh, boy. Chastain got the advantage, but he lost the momentum. Slide job by Casey Roberts. Here comes Johnny Chastain to the inside. He'll take the lead. Oliver to the outside of Hedgecock. Roberts will take a peek underneath Chastain. Side by side at the line, it's Chastain. Three wide for the lead. Now as Corey Hedgecock throws his name in, and he just threw it all away. Corey Hedgecock just spun in turn two. Caution flag is out, and Hedgecock will go tail. Corey Hedgecock's got his work cut out for him now as the 23 loops it, coming out of turn two by himself. Eight will come out of this. Right now, Bo Eaton in the eighth and final transfer spot. Here we go. Mashburn and Winger battle for the number four spot. Hedgecock looks to the inside of Craig Greer. Casey Roberts will show the nose to Chastain. Nothing doing out of four. Down the back stretch and into turn number three. Johnny Chastain in command. He'll fire down that back stretch and into turn number three as Roberts trying to track him down but losing ground. Now Parker to the outside of Painter. Corey Hedgecock in the eighth and final transfer spot. Closing in on the end of heat number two. Leader Johnny Chastain looking to get starting position number six tonight. White flag the next time by. Oh, and Winger broke traction. That allowed Masper to catch back up. One lap to go for Chastain. Down the back chute into turn number three for the final time. Johnny Chastain wins. He'll start sixth tonight. Mike Casey Roberts will join in. Jamie Oliver, Ashton Winger, George Mashburn in the show, Bobby Painter, Corey Hedgecock, and Bo Eaton. So Bo Eaton will get in the show with the eighth and final transfer spot by Johnny Chastain. He will start six with the win. So if everything looks good, we're going to see one to go right here. Let's see. We'll stay cautioned. And it is one to go. Hang on. 22 drivers about to blast out of turn number four. Jonathan Davenport, David Payne about to sling it and bring it for 40. Side by side, they work out of the corner. Green is out, and we are underway. And it's going to be David Payne with the early advantage. He'll put Davenport in the hip pocket. McIntosh will go to third. Skyler Marler, here comes his older brother Mike. Lap number one goes to the coach. Now Mike Marler all over his brother Skyler Marler and Johnny Chastain right there with him. Kenny Collins high and Sean Chastain now low. Nowhere for Casey Roberts to go early. It's all David Payne with Davenport tracking him down. Three wide for the number eight spot. They'll go four wide out of turn four. Leader Payne is setting a torrid pace. Right up by the wall was Craig Greer. He'll straighten it out. Now Payne's going to have to deal with the slower cars. First in line is going to be Craig Greer, then Bowie. That's going to allow Jonathan Davenport to close the gap a little bit. Move over flag being given to the two back markers as Payne is hot and heavy. Payne will sidestep Greer, Davenport, McIntosh, Marler. Now Payne, got to be careful, crossing gingerly. A little contact between McIntosh and Davenport. Now Payne's got clear sailing for a little bit. Doug Smith next in line. Mikey Marler. All over McIntosh. Three wide out of turn number four. Oh, close quarters between Sean Chastain, Casey Roberts. They straighten it out. Johnny Chastain and Kenny Collins battling. Davenport's got McIntosh in his rearview mirror. And the coach continues to show the way. And trouble in turn number four as McIntosh and Doug Smith come together. Smith will go to the tail. Caution is out. It's time to go. Out of turn number four, David Payne fires. We go back to racing. Davenport gets the nose under the coach. Not enough. McIntosh right there with him. Three cars under a blanket, and caution waves. Awry on the PPM car. So he will surrender a top five. We're ready to go. Green is out. Oh, and boy, did Payne throw a block. And that opened up the door for McIntosh. Slide job by Davenport. Three wide for the lead. Oh, Payne. He'll try the slider on Davenport. It'll pay off. Davenport tries to thread the needle and does. Oh, Davenport just shot through there. McIntosh the second. Wow. Now Donald McIntosh wants the lead. Davenport says no. Payne comes back. Here comes Marler. It ain't over, boys and girls. What a move. Doug Smith is in. Doug Smith calls it quits. Casey Roberts running fifth. Oh, and trouble on the A19 of Ledford. Caution is out. Danny Ledford in the A19 brings out the caution. Bo Eaton, a sympathy spin. The high-speed line dance will work its way out of turn number four. And we go back to racing. Oh, and we got trouble. Jamie Oliver just got lifted off the ground. Ashton Winger got him. Oliver got airborne. And they're both going to slow down for caution. Ashton Winger got into Jamie Oliver, no fault of anybody. Oliver got up in the air. Both cars slowed down, so I think both cars will probably go tail. And Mashburn paid the price on the right rear quarter. Here we go. You just couldn't see coming back. Out of four they come, and we're going. Here comes Marler. Here comes McIntosh. So McIntosh grabs second, gives it right back up. Marler will go to the outside a little. Mac Roberts on the bottom, and it's all Davenport. Clear sailing for Superman right now. Kenny Collins running in six, Chastain seven, Chastain eight. Ivanen and King, your top 10. Thirteen in the books right now, 27 to go. Casey Roberts continues to show the nose to Mike Marler. Marler puts the pressure on McIntosh. Sean Chastain gets around Johnny. Davenport has nothing but clean and green racetrack right now. The Chastains continue to go at it side by side across the line. Now Davenport's going to catch up to the slower cars in the field once again. Time to start making decisions. Craig Greer staying on the bottom of the racetrack, allowing Davenport to use the high side. Bo Eaton next on the hit list. That's it for Craig Greer. He's pulling it in. Seven cars done. Oh, sideways for Eaton, but he gathered it back up. So Bo Eaton will continue to pace around the speedway. Well, the aid of pain keeping Davenport in the crosshairs. We'll see if he's able to have something for him in the second half. Halfway this time by, and the coach is stalking. Ready to pounce. 20 in, 20 to go. It ain't over. Davenport down to a three-car length advantage. And it's going to get closer as Payne continues to close the gap. And trouble right there in turn four. We've got a car stalled in four, and it's Bo Eaton. And caution comes out just when Payne was making up real estate. Randy Weaver owns the 116, and Davenport drives it, and he's driving it well right now. So we're back underway. Again, McIntosh will dive underneath Payne to no avail. Same thing with Casey Roberts. They're trying to make the bottom work. They stay committed to the hub. Kenny Collins with a great run right now in the number six spot. Oh, and Marler had nowhere to go as he got a run going into three. McIntosh wasn't as fast. He was setting up. Marler had nowhere to go. Got a piece of the... Killer likes it. It's good enough. Out of four they come. Green flag back in the air. Payne will look to the inside. Kenny Collins takes the number five spot. He'll go around Sean and Johnny Chastain. So Kenny Collins working in the top five. Davenport opens up the advantage on Payne. Now all of a sudden Marler has caught the second place car. Here we go. Mike Marler to the inside, doesn't pay off. Sean Chastain continues the battle with Johnny. Oh, and Ivan and Lloyd got crossed up. He settles it down. Donald McIntosh trying to work back around these cars because Corey Hedgecock was only trailing him by 4 points. And right now, I believe Hedgecock will be the new point leader heading to Richmond if it stays this way. Into turns three and four, it is all Jonathan Davenport. They have settled down. They're gonna race this one to the end. Leader Davenport works out of turn number four, and that big advantage is starting to evaporate again. Now Kenny Collins wants more. He's going to go after the 101 of Casey Roberts. Kenny Collins got himself a solid piece. We're getting close to the five to go. Collins working on Roberts. Top three have pulled away. Davenport, Payne, and Marler. Now Davenport's going to have to deal with the 13 of George Mashburn. That'll slow his progress a little bit. So a slide job by Davenport to clear Mashburn. David Payne, he's getting into the mix. Marler going after Payne. Mashburn wants a piece of all of them. Five to go. Five laps remain for Davenport to win his second straight race. Payne isn't giving up, though. Four laps remaining, and the coach wants it. Well, Mashburn, he paid his pit pass money. He wants to visit every inch of the racetrack before it's over. And he's doing it. So Marler says, you know what? Three laps to go. What the heck? He's going to get involved. They're going to get the two to go right here. White flag the next time by. White flag coming up. And they're going to close in on lap traffic at the end. Payne's got to give it everything he's got and then some if he wants a shot. We've got one to go. Down the back chute, Davenport will lead him. Ivan and Lloyd off the pace as he got sideways. Checkered flag is gone away. Second night in a row, Jonathan Davenport goes to victory lane. The coach will follow him along with Marler. It'll be Casey Roberts and Kenny Collins. JD, I'm telling you what, it had to be fun. Doing those slide jobs early in the race, grabbing that lead and then having to hang on and go through that lap traffic. Looked like you were probably smiling inside that cockpit.
Yeah, definitely. You know, this place is pretty top dominant all night. And I knew David, he's really good here. He'd be hard to pass in traffic and everything, especially when Ray told everybody just go ahead and move to the bottom. And then I knew it would pretty much be clear sailing from then, so I was going to have to get something done on one of those restarts. And I come under him on the first one there, and I didn't get quite as good as run, but I got a little bit better run than I thought I did, so I thought I'd try the next. And, you know, just the outside so dominant coming off the corner here, and just got a big run on him. And I hope I gave him enough room when I slid him there, and he slid me back. And Donald was there, and we was three wide, man. That was a blast there for sure.
You said last night that driving this Randy Weaver car is just so much fun because it's so easy, it's comfortable. You going to get back in it at some point when you get time?
Yeah, I sure hope so. You know, I just, like you said, this thing is a pleasure to drive. They really got a really good piece and a good program going with Longhorn by Weaver here. And, you know, I don't know. We might work out some more dates. I'm so busy with the Lucas Oil Series and running the other bigger shows with the six car. And just got to thank, you know, Kevin and Leroy for allowing me to come out and especially come here to Tri-County to my home track. I love coming here. I love this crowd. And really blessed to be able to win in front of my friends and family and let little man talk on the microphone.
You want to say something to everybody?
No.
The good news is it's a short drive home, so enjoy it here tonight. Glad to have you around whenever you come to the bonus series, Southern Nationals, and of course, good luck on the Lucas Oil Late Model Dirt Series.
Well, thank you, and once again, I'd like to thank Josh, Pearl, Vinny, and Rusty, Chipstone, and Randy Wade for giving me this opportunity, and thanks for everybody coming out and supporting this great track. I hope Ray keeps it for many, many years.
Hopefully that'll happen. JD, nice job again, buddy. Enjoy it.
Thank you.
Jonathan Davenport, he'll get the broom out tonight. Well, let's talk to the driver to put on a heck of a show here tonight, the coach, David Payne, out of Murphy. David, man, oh, man, all over the racetrack, slide jobs, taking the lead. It had to be fun for you, too. I know second ain't what you came here for, but let's face it, second ain't all bad either.
Yeah, second ain't bad. We had a good race car. I think we were as good as Jonathan was. You know, that deal on that start, we didn't need a restart, and he got a run there, laid back, and got that run. Eight wheels scotch up a little better than four do, but, you know, congratulations to those guys, and, you know, we'll take second and try to build on it.
Just wondering, when that last caution came out, you were closing the gap on JD, and if we would have run to the end, what do you think?
It was going to take lap traffic or something, you know, to give me an opportunity because, you know, there just wasn't enough racetrack to really drive down in there below somebody, but, you know, it was interesting, so we'll go home and try again.
I'd have to say the two hometown boys kind of held off the bullies.
That's right. It's good to run well here at home. You know, I said that last time, and it's always good to come back home. We've had a tough weekend with four nights of racing. Had to change an engine this morning, so hats off to my guys and all these people that with car helped put us together.
Good news is, just like JD, you ain't got far to go home.
That's right. Short drive.
By the guy, for all intent purposes, had a pretty good weekend. Two wins, a third. And last night, obviously not your fault, Mike. You're just wrong place, wrong time. But looks like everything came back together. His Delk equipment machine seemed to work pretty good tonight.
Yeah, I'd like to thank Josh and Jerry here and Shannon and Lisa Bearden down at Capitol. They flew in there last night and helped us get this car patched up. It didn't look like it was going to be able to race today, but they got me back here. So I'd like to say thanks to them. We had a good car tonight.
Your wife, Stacy, said you guys are up to like 3:30 putting this thing back together after that start over at Rome where, you know, one car gets sideways and everybody behind pays the price. So you guys did a lot of work.
Yeah, I guess David and I both benefited. He got turned around and I drilled him. So so we're both here tonight and made some stuff happen. So, but yeah, you know, it takes a team effort to get all this going. And just a fun race tonight. You know, I hope the fans enjoyed it. And looks like you got a big crowd, a lot of young people here. It just looks like a very fun atmosphere. So glad to see everybody out.
Little brother keeps trying to get ahead of you. He got you tonight by being in the dash, but you got him by finishing ahead of him in the feature. You guys have anything going on the side there? Any kind of silent bets that you guys have? Who's going to finish to get a who?
No, I just want him to do the best he can do and try to help him. Like today, you got out here and made sure because I had qualified and kind of missed the line a little bit, and I wanted to make sure he knew where it was. So, but unfortunately, he broke something there. But it looked like he was running right behind me when he broke. So he's coming along, getting better and better, and. You know, a little experience. He'll be right up here with us.
No doubt about it. So a pretty good weekend all in all, Mike. Congrats, and we'll see you again real soon.
Yeah, thanks to everybody for coming out. Ray Cook, you know, really a cool guy to be around and got an awesome little racetrack here.
Mike Marler coming home third. The coach comes home second, and Jonathan Davenport wins his second.